Often when I sit to think about it, I do realize that I have a lot to be thankful about. What I'm thankful about the most is the fact that I get to experience so many different cuisines and culture. This year, I decided to do something different and venture out and experience the tribal cultures in our country. So this time, I decided to find out how the Oraon community in the outskirts of North Bengal live. They have been calling these tea estates near the foothills and the Doha regions their home for ages now, and I got to be a part of their life for one afternoon. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. If you're new to my channel, my name is Mohana and I'm a travel and food vlogger. And today I'm going to be doing something very exciting, something that I had been planning for months. I had been going back and forth with my host through messages since the past couple of months to plan and execute this day. And it's going to be pretty exciting. I am super stoked about this. So what I'm doing is basically I'm going to someone's place. I have been invited to her place and we basically grew up together, so we have a lot of history together. And we spent like all of our teenage years in the same house doing the same things. Thing is, I never visited her place before, and now she's married, she has a kid, and her life is completely different to mine. And as you guys might know, I love experiencing different food and cultures, anything which is different to mine. And of course, I try my best to be ethical while portraying other cultures, and especially today, since I'm going to be doing a tribal food and culture series. She belongs to the Oraon tribe, Oraon community, and I would love to experience her way of living, her food, her culture, and see life through her eyes maybe. So without further ado, I am going to jump straight into the vlog, and then probably I'm going to talk a little bit about the Oraon tribe. Sharmila and her family live deep inside the Matidhar Tea Estate, which is located in Ghoshpukur, a few kilometers outside Siliguri. In India, as a token of love, sweets are given to the host when you visit their house for the first time. In exchange, Sharmila shook hands with us and welcomed us into her home.
Pratibha.
Pratibha. Aapka?
So they just celebrated Christmas and I see a manger. So I'm finally at our host's place, Sharmila. So her place is basically a 10-minute drive from Bidhannagar, the toll plaza. She lives in a tea estate, and basically what we are trying to do is so she belongs to the Oraon tribe, and the tribe, they are a major portion of their population live in Chota Nagpur plateau. But according to their subaltern history, they had been displaced from their original home, and that's when they came down and started living near Chota Nagpur. But a major chunk of their population also live in Orissa, in Bengal and Bangladesh and many other places, and they are usually employed in these tea estates. So I just wanted to see how they live and how how their way of living, their food, their culture. So I think basically what we are gonna do is and also we are gonna watch like their dance performance. So I think their history is depicted through their music and dance, and sometimes it's a lot about love stories as well. So I would love to see. I wouldn't understand possibly, so I'm gonna ask her to explain, and I'm gonna ask her to talk about her life as well a little bit, and we can understand better about her culture then. Soon after, they officially welcomed us into their home and their hearts by washing our feet and our hands. That gesture was enough to show us their warmth and their welcoming nature.
We are taking a stroll around trying to see the village.
After this, Sharmila's husband, our host, offered to take us around the village. We spotted a lot of cute puppies, hens, goats running around, a lot of cute little children playing. We also saw the irrigation facility from where water is drawn to water the entire tea estate, and a lot of fishermen and people were bathing in the river.
A lot of these houses have their own home gardens, which is like so amazing. Pratibha, kaun si class mein ho abhi?
Nursery.
Nursery. Ishmita, kaun si class mein? Kaun si class mein? We see a lot of crowds and everyone forming.
By the time we returned, the girls were all decked up in their colorful yellow and red saris, all set to perform and dance to the tunes of the music.
Now, I think it's gonna start. So we have everyone ready in their traditional attires.
However, I wasn't satisfied. I wanted something more. I wanted to be a part of the dance performance as well. So when they requested me to join in, I was overjoyed and readily accepted the offer. Soon, they taught me how to match up to their steps, and very soon I was performing with them as well.
गाना है ना तो क्या जन चमकता है अच्छा ये क्रिसमस था इसी ओके
नहीं हम गाना के द्वारा ये पता किया कि हम लोग का क्रिसमस आ रहा है फिर हम लोग का ये पता किया कि क्रिसमस आ गया है फिर यीशु राजा का जन्म हुआ है चरनी में और चरनी में लेटा हुआ है कपड़े के द्वारा इस सब बताया
अच्छा और आप लोग
जन्म गौशाले में हुआ है
अच्छा और आप लोगों ने ये अपने भाषा में ये गाना गाया और आप लोग जो पहने हुए हो ये मतलब आपका ट्रेडिशनल
ट्रेडिशनल पोशाक है
पोशाक है आप लोग ओराओ कम्युनिटी के ही हो अच्छा और ज्यादातर आप लोग क्रिसमस ही मनाते हो मतलब आप लोग क्रिश्चियन ही हो
मिला
मिक्स मिक्स है
खिचड़ी
ओके
सब जात भी है और खिचड़ी है आदिवासी में सब जात भी है
अच्छा
हम लोग ने के ओराओ ही है मेल
आप लोग कब से यहाँ पे रह रहे हो
जन्म से
ही
अच्छा हम लोग से जानना चाह रहे हो कि ये लोग कहाँ से आए हैं तो ये आंटी है मेरा और ये आंटी का बेटी मोहना गांगुली वो भाई महर्षि गांगुली तो मैं इन्हीं लोग के घर में पली बड़ी हूँ और इन्हीं लोग ने मुझको पढ़ाया जो भी हूँ आंटी के वजह से इसलिए आंटी को जोर से ताली मार दिया
थैंक यू सो मच
आप लोग को भी थैंक यू
बहुत अच्छा हुआ आप लोगों को डांस
बहुत सुंदर डांस था आप लोग बहुत सुंदर भी लग रही हो सब सब मुझे बहुत ब्यूटी सब कलर का होता है ऐसे ब्लैक व्हाइट कुछ नहीं होता बट आप लोग जो यू नो सब इयररिंग्स वगैरह मैं देख रही थी बहुत सुंदर है किसी का तो मैंने शूज देखा बहुत सुंदर है वो ब्लैक कलर का शूज थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू बच्चा पार्टी हाय बोलना
हाय बोलो
After the very entertaining dance performance, Sharmila invited us to her backyard where she had set up the table for our lunch. But before that, she invited me to her kitchen and I got to see her toss out one of the dishes that she had made for lunch. And trust me, I'm not even exaggerating when I say that lunch was one of the best lunches that I've ever had in my life.
I am in her kitchen and she's cooked like a few things for us, so I am very excited. And Pratibha has been stealing food, so did my mother. She came and stole some food. So when she used to stay with us and she used to come to her place like here, she used to make these rotis and go back home. So I used to have a gala time when I was a kid.
In the kitchen, Sharmila had cooked up a storm for us. She made these deep-fried dough balls called Parapka Roti or Phagun Roti, and with that she made this amazing and yummy looking beef curry.
Already made some. So these are called what? Parapka Roti. Phagun Roti. Parapka Roti.
Parapka Roti.
Looks really nice. This is beef curry.
After she was done frying her last batch of the Phagun rotis, food was served and we couldn't be happier since we were really hungry and the smell and the sight was making us even hungrier.
So I have this dough ball, the roti kind of thing with the beef curry, and let me just dip into the curry. And the curry is really tasty and I love how the roti is like sweet and the curry is spicy, so it has this sweet and spicy combination. These are made of rice flour, maida, coconut shavings and peanut.
Suji.
And suji also, semolina. And it goes wonderful with the spicy beef curry. And there is some saag as well. It is made with potato. Let me take a beef chunk. It's tender. It's cooked very well. Like the right amount of spice, not too spicy. So because she knows, I think, how much spice we have, so she's made it kind of mild. While we are eating, there's a party of them waiting for us to drop any food. Some of them are going after the hen. We have some rice, dal, and we'll take a little bit of the saag.
Meat.
I'll take some potato. I'll take a small bite of the saag and dal rice. Tastes really nice, very earthy. Some papad feels very wholesome kind of meal, and it's not very different from the way Bengalis cook. I think the saag is very different, it's just stir fried. The dal is very similar to the way Bengalis eat, make their dal. The rice, the grain is very different. What grain is ye rice ka grain kaun sa hai?
Nunia chal.
So it ki mane this is where they store their rice grains. Maybe I'll show it later. So the rice grain is very different, as you can see, it's small. I'm gonna take a little bit of the beef and curry.
The curry tasted as good as it did with the roti. So with the rice, I mixed it. I took a chunk of the beef and I took some papad and made it into a one-biter.
So we just finished a very hearty meal and it was all very simple and tasty. She's sending back those dough balls and some chawal for us, and she was also very keen on sending a hen, which we didn't want to take because we had no idea how to take it back and what to do with it. So I'm going to ask her to show the hen. this was supposed to go back home with us, but bye. They're having a gala feast of the bones. Very excited, running around. Ron, how was the food?
It was good. It was very good.
You liked it? How was the food?
Really good.
Why do you have lipstick all over your face?
Really, it was good.
Okay. So you guys might be wondering about their diet, and although a lot of them traditionally they were Hindu as their primary religion, a lot of them eventually, with the spread of missionaries, a lot of them eventually became Christians, and so their diet is very amalgamated. Like, people don't really care about the meat they eat. Usually they forage for they are foragers in nature. They eat any kind of meat, so they don't really have all of those divisions based on religion. Even the Hindus, maybe some of them have learned to not eat, more or less everyone eats every kind of meat. And traditionally they were basically worshippers of the land, and they have, even their Hinduism has a lot, very different elements of Hinduism in their practice than traditional Brahmanical traditions that we know.
However, not everything is as flowery as it looks. There are some recurrent issues in the society as well, like lack of proper education, and alcoholism is a huge problem in the Oraon community. In fact, in any tribal community living in the outskirts of the city.
यहाँ से different मतलब रहन सहन क्या different कैसा है?
Difference यही है कि यहाँ पे ज़्यादा पढ़े लिखे नहीं हैं, अंधविश्वास वही, और हम लोग का जात में ज़्यादातर वही सारा पीते हैं उसमें ही ज़्यादातर वही है. और बाकी सब ठीक है, कुछ भी बोलने से सुनते हैं.
और तुम लोगों में मतलब ऐसा मतलब हेड ऑफ द फैमिली क्या मर्द होते हैं, औरत होते हैं?
पिताजी
होते हैं, पर ऐसे कोई भेदभाव नहीं होता, सब सारे काम सब भी करते हैं. अच्छा,
हम लोग का एकदम सब फ्री है, कुछ
भी इक्वल है सब. So they're they also have their own home-based beer drink, which is called Hadia, and they make it of rice, fermented rice, right? And it's like a rice beer. It's white in color, white in color. But since she has a very strict Catholic faith, so she doesn't like. So because alcoholism is a prevalent issue in the community, so she prefers not bringing Hadia at home. So which is something which I can't show you guys. There are rice grains in this big basket. This one has been trying to sneak into the kitchen for a long time now.
By the time we were done with lunch, dusk was nearing the village, and it was time for us to head home as well. But my heart simply wasn't ready to leave the purity of our village life and head back to the city's hustle and bustle. The village women had started to set up small fires to beat the cold winter evenings, and the kids were still gleefully running around, while we bid farewell to our gracious hosts and returned to our lives with an aching heart and solemnly promising to return soon. To say the least, it was one of the most humbling experiences of my life. And just to be able to be with them, just to experience their culture, their way of living, it just makes me appreciate our culture so much, this country so much, and the variety of cultures and ethnicities and the kind of people that we have in this country that makes me truly, truly proud to be an Indian. And I just couldn't be more thankful to Sharmila and her near and dear ones to be able to let me into their lives and to allow me to look at their life and be a part of their community, even if it was just for one afternoon.